Zombieland. Life is about more than just survival. We were a family. Dysfunctional, sure, but what family isn't?
Merry Christmas! What would you like, little girl?
I'd really like for you to stop calling me little girl.
Do you know what I would like?
I don't give a what you know.
It felt so good to be on the move again.
Whoa! Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Hi, I'm Columbus.
Madison.
This is Tallahassee.
Hey, Paul Blart. Is this your dad? Seatbelt rule.
Oh, so she knows the rules?
I told her just a few of them.
73, and are there more?
You're cute.
I like it.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
So, you know, when it comes to sequels, I feel like sometimes it can be a little bit difficult to keep that momentum going, but you guys really, really brought it for this. Were there any challenges going into Double Tap that you didn't have in the first one?
I mean, I think the greatest challenge was how much time had passed. Like, you talk about momentum. We had zero momentum after 10 years. We had to find a way to get into the story, pick it up a long time later, and yet still have it impactful and feel like it had real momentum. So it came to figuring out how the zombies had evolved, how our characters had evolved, how the world around them had evolved. So we were looking at a little bit different kind of movie than the first. And once we locked into those things, it felt like it really did pick up steam, and it felt like it was a story that stood on its own.
And we really wanted to give the audience a sequel worthy of the audience's experience on the first one. It's partly why it took so long, those 10 years, because everyone held it to such a high standard, all of us. Woody and Emma and all the actors, us and Ruben and Gavin, all wanted to give the audience something that would not only not mar the experience of the first one, but kind of improve on it. So.
And at what point did you realize you wanted to incorporate Monster Jam, like monster trucks?
Our minds always go to what's the craziest way you could kill zombies. I mean, we have the Leaning Tower of Pisa falling on a zombie. We have. A wheat combine, but monster trucks is sort of the ultimate way, right? I mean, these big fat tires, you know, with a massive engine, the ability to flip through the air, and we just pictured that in a field of zombies, and that just made us smile.
It hadn't really been done in a movie either. You haven't seen monster trucks
not
in a
much.
Movie.
There was one
odd.
In Role Models for like 10 seconds, and Cannonball Run from the old
right.
days, but it hasn't been used that often, which was right in our wheelhouse.
Okay, we got this. Ho! You don't send a boy to do a man's job. We brought him here. We'll take care of it.
Yeah, you know what? Have at him.
Hasta la vista, baby. Terminator 2. Remember?
Woo! Ready, buddy?
He's still cool.
Woo!
Suck these bullets! Come on! Get you some!
Does anybody else find those two uniquely annoying?
Uniquely? No.
I don't love their chances.
Yeah, and they ignored Rule 52. Don't be afraid to ask for help.
And I love that you guys, you know, did really bring monster trucks to the forefront. You also, there's a certain kind of vibe with Zombieland, you know, like Rule number 34, like those kinds of things that really just speak to us. How do you incorporate those, and how do you find those moments to inject your personality into the films?
Well, I think it's all personality. Strangely, Zombieland is less about less about zombies and it's more about family, right? And we can all relate to that and all relate to kind of this dysfunctional group being brought together and how everyone interacts. And so we really tap into that character and those interactions more than we do the setting. We always say it's, you know, ordinary situations and extraordinary circumstances. The ordinary situations being the interaction of the family, the extraordinary circumstances obviously being these, you know,
Flesh-eating monsters,
right? I mean, something we can't relate to, something we can relate to, but you put them together and it feels kind of this heightened, grounded reality, so.
Would there ever be a possibility of doing Zombieland Triple Tap or something along those lines?
What's rule number 3, beware of bathrooms? Is that rule number 3?
I don't know.
Zombieland 3,
beware of bathrooms. Yeah, that's... But yeah, I mean, look, we'd love to make a third one. This one took 10 years. You know, good Lord willing, I don't know if we can wait another 10, but well, we'll see.
Final question for you guys. What's your favorite thing about zombies?
I think that you can kill them and not feel bad about it. Like, it's just really fun just to hit something over the head with a baseball bat and not have to feel too bad about it, because it is trying to eat you after all.
And I don't know, the favorite thing is that the throw up that comes out of their mouth is actually like this delicious applesauce. And so...
You've been a zombie.
I've been a zombie. I didn't make the final cut because every time I ran by camera, I started laughing.
He has this weird nervous tic when he's in front of camera. So he was like the zombie who wasn't taking things seriously enough to be on screen.
And the second unit director kept going, cut, cut.
Stop laughing.
Paul.
What's so funny?
What is funny? And I'm like, nothing's funny. I just can't stop laughing. But the viscous.
The Joker. You were like Joker from the movie. Remember, he's got the nervous tic that makes him laugh and he can't control it.
That's flattering. I'm flattered. I'm actually flattered. Thank you.
Thank you guys.
Thanks,
Thank
Amy.
Thank you, Amy.
We appreciate it.
My sister is gone. She picked up a boy. He's from Berkeley.
Berkeley?
You don't have weed, do you?
Do I look like the type of person that would have weed?
I'm sorry.
Boom!
Yeah? I have nothing against
hippies. I just want to beat the shit out of them.
We're gonna go get her. We ride it, dog.
Start talking.
You first.
My name's Tallahassee.
Die, zombie! Light him up! No! That's my ride!
Oh, my apologies, little Elvis!
Okay, is it me, or does he kind of remind you of...
I don't like you. At all.
I think you double parked. Or more perpendicular parked. Hope we don't get a ticket.
What is going on here?
What?
Hello, everyone.
Am I hallucinating?